A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 30th December, Monday, on the front page you have no legal rules framed yet for NRC. So this is Union Law Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad, who has said that rules have not yet been framed and there is a possibility that NRC may take place, but it will only be through a due legal process with rules for it being defined through adequate consultation. So this is the statement which he has given. He also says that there are hidden elements behind protests against Citizenship Amendment Act. And this is regarding government formation in Jharkhand. So here you can see Hemant Soren is of Jharkhand Janmukti Morcha is back as Jharkhand CM. Then below you have Amitabh Bachchan receiving Dada Saheb Phalke Award for 2018. The award is being presented by President Ramnath Kovind. On page 9 you have 3 years on, a mere 30% of Poshan Abhiyan funds used. So barring 3 states, it is said none of the governments used even half of the sum. So you can see the percentage utilization under the Poshan Abhiyan, which is a scheme launched by the central government in 2017 for nutrition. So here you can see it's a flagship program aimed at improving nutrition outcomes among pregnant women, lactating mothers and children by reducing the level of stunting, underweight, anemia and low birth weight by 2022. But you can see the percentage utilization among states, it's quite low. Except 3 states, you can see none have crossed 50% mark. That is Bihar, Mizoram and Himachal Pradesh, and also the Union Territory of Lakshadweep. So except these 4, none of the governments used even half of the sum granted in the past 3 years. Then below you have Navy plans 24 submarines to strengthen fleet. So this is what the Navy has informed the parliamentary panel. So parliamentary panel on defense has been informed that Navy wants to strengthen its underwater fleet and it plans to build 24 submarines, including 6 nuclear attack submarines. Also, Navy informed the parliamentary panel that medium refit life certification of submarine Sindhuranj was held up since Russian side has not been able to submit bank guarantees and integrity pact due to sanctions imposed by US. So USA has imposed sanctions on Russia since it has annexed Crimea from Ukraine. So there are other reasons also apart from this significant one. There is also CATSA, which affects India-US relations too because of sanctions on Russia. So that is there. So this is the detail being provided. So here you can see under Project 75 also 6 submarines, the Scorpion submarines, have been inducted into the Navy. Also Project 75I has been initiated for induction of more submarines. Navy, it is said, presently has 2 nuclear submarines, INS Arihant, which is indigenously built, and INS Chakra. The INS Chakra has been leased from Russia. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Arms and the Man. So this is regarding Army Chief General Bipin Rawat. It is said he crossed the line of military propriety in making political comments. So in the statement which he made in the context of protests against Citizenship Amendment Act as such is criticized here. That such statements should not come from military. And then this is Governance Index. So this is regarding the Government of India's exercise carried out on good governance index. So this is a nationwide comparative study of states on governance. So marking states on different parameters can incentivize performance. So that is appreciated in this editorial. So here you can see the details of this is also provided. So here you can see the Bimaru states. That is Bihar, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh. So these states continue to lag behind. Then this is the lead article, a dangerous law in state-sponsored hate. So this is regarding citizen Uttar Pradesh. It is said police bias and scale of violence against minorities are plumbing new depths. and this is for humane and autonomous police. So during such times of crisis, the focus needs to be on improving the quality of policing in the field rather than on political management. So how police has to manage, you know, such protests as such, how it should be humane and quality of policing should be improved is detailed out here. Then on the op-ed page you have, India needs a bottom-up growth model. So this article argues that India requires an employment and income strategy to guide its industry and trade policies. So what the government does to boost reform economy, to bring in reforms, it incentivizes large businesses. So industry and, you know, in general businesses are incentivized, trade is incentivized, and it would have trickle down effect on employment and income. But this article argues that India requires an employment and income strategy which would boost industry and trade. On page 12, you have Pakistan to host OIC meet on Kashmir CA. So this is regarding Organization of Islamic Cooperation. So there'll be, this is a 57 member international grouping, and Pakistan will hold its ministerial meeting in April 2020 on Jammu and Kashmir and Citizenship Amendment Act. And then here you have a Chief of Defense Staff can serve till 65 years, says government. So government has issued a gazette modifying the service rules of the Army, Navy and Air Force, enabling the appointment of Chief of Defence Staff and fixing the upper age limit to 65 years. So the tenure of Chief of Defence Staff post is not yet fixed, but upper age limit has been. Then this is, due process is a must to seek damages. So Uttar Pradesh government's acceptance of 6.27 lakh from Muslim community as compensation for damages caused by public property looting anti-citizenship amendment act process protest lacks due process is what this article talks of. So we have seen this amount being gathered and paid to the UP government, but then due process has not been followed in this. Guidelines mandate court monitored system of assessment based on evidence. Then on international page, you have news regarding terror attack in New York, in Somalia, the bomb blast which took place, an accident in Egypt, and even here in Yemen. Then below you have, Ukraine rivals exchange 200 prisoners in controversial swap. So this is Ukraine and Russia-backed separatists in Ukraine's war-torn east region. So the two entities, that is Ukraine and these separatists in Ukraine who are supported by Russia, they exchanged 200 prisoners. So this swapping was for detained fighters and civilians and servicemen which have been kept captive in each of the two sites, on each of the two sides, for years. So this exchange took place. So steps have been taken to de-escalate tension too. And here you have, Putin thanks Trump for intelligence on attacks. So Russian President Vladimir Putin thanked US counterpart Donald Trump for intelligence that helped foil attacks on Russian soil. So this has been appreciated by Russia. So it was in regarding the arrest, which happened for the person who had planned the attack in St. Petersburg during New Year festivities. So this is a foiled terror attack. Then on Sundays on business page, you have money wise coverage. So this is for individual investments. So this can be skipped. Then on features page, actually you have this coverage on historical locations in Delhi. So this is important from culture perspective, knowing more about Qutub Minar, then Firoz Shah Kotla, Humayun's Tomb, which is a World Heritage Site, Nizamuddin Dargah, etc. So that is it. Then the last page has sports related news, which is not important. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asr.com. Thank you.